feature gives you a position to say what you want to. And it just doesn't mean only about money. For us, films were never about just money. It was about saying something. Art is something which you talk about in a society, what is happening in your society. It's like a mirror. Whatever stories we tell, there has to be some kind of a moral story behind it. Why are we telling that story? When we were growing up, every 3 years, Dad was posted to some different city. So every 3 years, we had to make new friends. So for us, that became a part of life, that nothing was constant. Everything was on a move. So that's how it helped me when I shifted my career, job, because I wasn't afraid. Now, at this age, I wouldn't be that foolhardy and taking those kind of risks. It'll be calculated. I mean, obviously, as I said, with my films, I take risks, but these are more pragmatic way of risk-taking. So money-wise, same thing for the company also when we do, as I told you. I work on a bare minimum level where not the best case scenarios ever. So I do research and analysis of the funding of the film basis, the worst case scenario. That worst case, this film doesn't work. What will happen? So at least this bare minimum can be recovered. So that's how I work. And beyond that, whatever comes is. So that's how, for money also, I'm conservative that way. I'm not a very market savvy in terms of investments. I have a fund manager, and a fixed amount I give, and they say don't ask for 2-3 years, and after a point it multiplies. Personally, I have not much of a, I'm not much of a financial whiz kid in terms of my personal hat. So for me, I am, I think, the old school guy. So the investments I've made are in properties. I'm very good for my business, but in terms of money, I'm not at all good. For on a personal level, not very ambitious about money. For me, the kick that I get out of films is for the film to be successful. That's why I make those financial decisions. My philosophy is you work, money will automatically come. But if you look at money and you keep on running behind money, it'll go further. Because you will be looking at money, you will not be looking at your work. I think the society I grew up in, it was a very, you work today, live for today. Like if you go to Northeast and all, it's nobody, you will not find too many people who invest or something. I'll give you a simple example over there. You would go to someone's house, it will look like a thatched house, but you park yourself over there, you'll see the best bike over there, you'll see the best music system over there, and you'll find the best clothes. That's how the tribals lived. They were like, we are very clear, all this liquid that I'm collecting, for whom? For the next generation. I am of the opinion that give them the best possible education, let them earn their own money. I didn't inherit anything from my dad. What I inherited was he gave me a great education, got me into a situation where I could make my own money in my own way, and I live my life the way I want to. So I don't want to compromise on my living today for my next generation. So as far as the fund manager is concerned, but I started off with very small amounts, and as the trust grew and the way the person was working and showing me the results, and that's how I started increasing the fund flow to him. Two things. One is honesty, very important. And second is knowledge of the business, what they are doing. A life insurance, just as a back of your mind to have that safety net that, okay, fine, whatever you're doing. This was that one little liquid which is there beyond the other liquid that would be there. Medical, definitely I looked at it because the way the medical is going and the expenses which are there in the medical, and certainly when your family is increasing and then you have the kind of ailments that are coming in because of all the fertilizers that we eat instead of fruits now. So all this will come in handy. You will need it. I mean, you try to keep yourself fit, but ultimately the way the situation is in the country, you are bound to fall sick. So and at that stage, if you have, it's a godsend. Every project that we do, we insure. So like when I do a feature film, it's 25 crores which is there. Anything can happen. There can be fire, there can be one day of shoot can get cancelled because of band happening, or because unseasonal rain, or if we are shooting in the hills, snowfall and you can't shoot. So the one day of cost of 120 people sitting over there, they stay, their daily wage, everything. So it's a huge amount of money. So we insure every project that we go in for. See, first is definitely follow your heart, but then be rational. And then secondly, today's youth, the biggest thing is have patience. None of them have patience. They think that in 2 years they will reach here to here. They don't see people have worked 20 years to reach a certain place. It takes time. That's how you will master your knowledge of your field. You don't run after money. Don't run after money ever. Run after your passion. Your passion will automatically feed you and will get you the money, even more at times. Listen to good music, good food, good travel, and provide best for the family. That's about it. Today what I want, I can get that. I want to go and watch a football game in Europe. I'll travel, watch it. That's my kick. I want to watch a good concert in Berlin. I'll go and watch. So for me, these are the small things which I think that money comes handy for me and never for the next generation. When you are working, you have your desires, you should never kill them. I always feel that the more desire you have, you will earn more money, because if you don't have any passion, you don't want that, then how will you earn money?